All right, here we go. Round two, mud deck. We win their die roll. And we choose to play first, obviously. And let's see what we have in our hand. Ancient Tomb, Grimmalith, and Chalice of the Void. So actually, I'm just going to lead off with Ancient Tomb and Chalice for one. Since Legacy, one mana cast spells are pretty much a big staple, and it kind of removes our opponent from being able to play Swords of Plowshare if they happen to have it. Also gets rid of Brainstorm, so that's why I'm going to go with it. Since we have no idea what they're playing, I feel that's probably the best play at this point in the game. We could play Grim Monolith, but that would accomplish nothing as we can't really play anything. And worst case, oh, look at that. Boom. Fastest game won ever. Chalice, boom. For one, game over. So I'm going to add in Trinisphere because it looks like they do not want us to do that. So I'm taking out the spine because I have no idea what they're playing. Probably like a storm deck. So I'm going to actually throw Witchbane in there and take out the Metamorph. And I think that should be good. All right. This hand is not nearly as exciting, but still very good hand. Trying to think here. Obviously, want to lay down our Ancient Tomb first, Grim Monolith, but I don't know if we want to tap out for our Metalworker because it's eh. Actually, yeah, we'll go with it and we'll see what happens. I'd like to get the lodestone out, turn two. Oh, looks like they are not playing the storm deck. Looks like they are playing burn or aggro zoo kind of deck. So draw a land, that's cool. Just helps in our library for us a little bit. Forge Master. Boom chicka wow wow. Gonna throw down the monolith here and just pass the turn. And then next turn I'll lay down the Lodestone Golem, since it gives us a beefy blocker and then he has to start paying one more colorless for the spells he plays. And look at that, man. We are just top decking lands like a boss today. And they might actually be mana screwed. Nope. They are definitely not mana screwed. So looking more like the red burn deck, which is fine. Lavamancer is not too threatening yet. However, we are very low on life. So, here, I'm going to tap out my Grim Monolith and Ancient Tomb to throw down the Lodestone Golem. And then I'll play Wasteland and I'll get rid of the Plateau. That way, he cannot play any spells. However, he can still activate his Lavamancer, so we do not want to block the Goblin Guide with our Lodestone. Not yet, anyway. We are getting pretty low on life. Ancient Tomb really hurts us that way, but. We will know what we're facing for sideboard if we go into round three this time. So, plays another Plateau. Cast a lightning bolt, good choice. Just clear the battlefield and tack in for 3 damage. Seems good to me. Trinisphere off the top. Not ideal for us. We're gonna play our cavern here, naming construct. This is a tough decision. We play metal worker, and he just shoots it down. I'm just gonna. Trying to think here, because he has 3 damage on his side of the board. And we take 2 if we tap the Ancient Tomb. Next turn, I'd like to get the Forge Master out, but we do not have. Yeah, I don't foresee us winning this one. I think we are just dead here. Because no matter what I do, if I tap out the Ancient Tomb, that puts us in kill range. So. That will be game. I'll concede this game and we'll go on to round 3. So this round is turning out to be quite the quick round. Arbiter. Karn's not very good in here. I'll put in an Arbiter. Witchbane is actually still pretty good. So, good call on the Witchbane there. Snang Bridge doesn't have a ton of creatures. And the Arbiter is probably a better choice anyway. So, I don't see anything else I really want to take out. So, I'll submit and hopefully we can make this work. And this is a terrible hand that I am definitely mulligan. One land and tons of high mana spells. Oh, why do you tempt me? Well, we do have our Greaves and our Metalworker, but we have no land. I mean, we have the Wasteland and Mox Opal, but still. Ugh. I just hate mulligan to 5, especially in this deck. Oh man. I mean, if we can get him out though, I mean, we're set. We got Wyrmcoil and Forge Master. I'm gonna keep it. It's probably not the best idea to keep, but I'm gonna keep. That's just what I'm gonna do. So, we're just gonna live with the consequences if we lose and we don't draw any land, so. We're hoping to top deck here. But I don't really foresee me getting a really good 5-card hand in this deck. Yeah, we're going to just take the 4. Because after one turn, it's going to start doing way more than just 4 damage to us. So still can't play anything, so. Pass turn. Staff of Domination is pretty crazy with Metalworker, though. So, actually, the hand's actually turning out to be quite good. This little 3-card combo here is very, very devastating. We are already at 12 life, though. Chalice. Oh, man. Come on, land. I mean, worst case scenario, I can throw the Chalice down for 0 and hopefully get another artifact into play. Oh my gosh. Yes. And then we can have our Mox Opal come online. However, he has quite a bit of mana. This is not looking good for us. I probably should have mulliganed. Even though I thought against it, I was kind of hoping to be a little more lucky with the top deck, but that's not turning out to be the case. So we made the decision, and I am paying for it now. But man, he is flooded. He could just have a handful of instants, though, so. Land Yep, price of progress. Boom, there goes 2 damage. Okay. Holy cow. About time. So, I'm going to play the Grim Monolith here. Part of me wants to play the Chalice for one. Let's look at our options here. We played Chalice for one right here. And we can throw down Lightning Greaves. Next turn we can play Metalworker and equip our Lightning Greaves. I think that is probably the best. Because we do not have enough to do Metalworker and Greaves this turn. Oh crap. Yep. So, okay, that's right. So I'm going to use 2 of this to use a Chalice, which will activate our Mox Opal, and then we can play our Lightning Greaves. So if you have any 1 mana cost spells, you need to play them now. We are very low. This could actually be the kill right here. Oh, it's not. So we're still in this. Play Lightning Greaves. And pass the turn and just pray he doesn't have any more burn spells that aren't 1 mana. Oblivion Ring. Lovely. Probably going to get rid of the Chalice here. Yep. Does he have it? Goblin Guide. Okay. Whew. Well, that pretty much just puts us really, really low. So, we pretty much have to win here. And seeing as how he's tapped out, I do not think he has Fire Blast, or else he probably would have used it already. Although he could just be waiting for my upkeep, but I don't know why you'd do that. So, this is what's going to go down. I'm going to play Metalworker here. And equip our Greaves to it. Boom! Reveal all of our artifacts. That's right. Play our Staff of Domination. And we're going to untap target creature. Oh, crap. We can't do that because of the Lightning Greaves. Crap. Forgot about that. Oh, man. That's annoying. So, I'm going to have to play our Forge Master here. Yeah, I did not even think about that. It was my bad. I'm going to play it on the Forge Master here. Boom! So we can activate its ability. I'm going to get rid of the Mox Opal here, Grim Monolith, and the Forge Master. I might actually just get the Platinum Empyrean here. There is a good chance, however, that our opponent may have an Oblivion Ring. Actually, no, let's just go for the kill right now. I'm just going to get Blightsteel Colossus and attach Lightning Greaves to it. And that should be game. So, dang. That was a close one, guys. But luckily, there you have it. We pulled off round two there with the mud deck. Very, very intense close game there. So hope you guys enjoyed it. I will see you on round three. Thanks for watching.